First, we need to determine how far in wavelengths this load impedance dot needs to be rotated. So first we find the distance in terms of wavelength. So we take 0.18 meters, divide by the wavelength, which here is a convenient 1 meter, and we find we need to rotate 0.18 wavelengths. And we're rotating this dot around the Smith chart. So we can draw a straight line from the center of the Smith chart. We get a value of 0.18, and so we would rotate 0.18 wavelengths over here. So if you add 0.18 plus 0.18, you'll get 0.36, and that's how you know you'll at the right point. So I'm labeling this Z in. That's the input impedance at that distance. And also remember, we're going towards the generator because we were at the load, so we're going in the clockwise direction to go towards the generator. Then we can get the magnitude of the reflection coefficient by using the radial scale at the bottom of the Smith chart. So that hasn't changed from what we had before. It's still 0.82. And then we can obtain the angle of the reflection coefficient using the angle of reflection coefficient in degrees scale. And we get minus 79.2 degrees. And we can check this by comparing against the analytical calculated phase shifted reflection coefficient. And so if we calculate theta r minus 2 beta d, we would expect to get something similar. So we have 51 degrees minus 2 times 2 pi over 1, since the wavelength is 1, times 0.18, and let's see, this is in radians automatically, so we need to convert it to degrees. So let me multiply here by 180 degrees over pi, and altogether we get minus 78.6 degrees. So since we're in the Smith chart, we're kind of eyeballing things, this is a pretty good comparison with what we get from the Smith chart.